أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم، ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما. يريد الله أن يخفف عنكم، وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا. صدق الله العظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah doth wish to turn to you, but the wish of those who follow their lusts is that ye should turn away from him, far, far away. Allah doth wish to lighten your burdens, for man was created weak in resolution. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to another edition of Islam for Europeans. I'm your host, Robert. And please like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for your support. And hopefully we can create more content here at Islam for Europeans and do more things so you know, we can grow this channel and this network from the ground up. But I wanted to talk about Sneako's recent conversion to Islam. As you know, Sneako is a very famous YouTube personality who's associated with the was I guess still kind of associated with the Red Pill movement, and that includes other YouTubers such as Andrew and Tristan Tate, who also converted to Islam. Now I you know been watching a lot of Sneako's videos. As you know, Sneako recently converted to Islam. He's been a YouTuber for several years until he was his both of his channels on YouTube were actually canceled at the time of his cancellation. He had around 2 million subscribers, and now he's made Hijra to Rumble, where he's mashallah getting a lot of subscribership. He's getting a real niche market. He's also interviewed such controversial figures such as Nick Fuentes. And most recently, after his conversion, he was interviewed by Pearl, Adjust Pearly Things. So, first and foremost, this message, if Sneako is watching this, welcome to Islam. Assalamu alaikum, Sneako. I think, you're doing quite a wonderful job of this very delicate balance and challenge of not just converting to Islam, but now, you have this enormous, YouTube channel, you're a YouTube celebrity. And on top of that, you just come into Islam. So, that's tough to, that's a challenge navigating in and of itself. And, Allah, tries, Allah makes it easy for us, once we, once we accept the faith and, he's able to, provide solutions for all the challenges that come our way. But I think that you've been able to really navigate, the whole, internet influencer, status that you've converted to Islam, and you're getting a lot of support from the Muslim community, which is great. Of course, there's always going to be haters, and they're going to express that on your channel, but at the same time, that comes with the territory. So, may Allah keep you on the straight path, and continue to guide you, and resolve all of your, all of your difficulties and give you success in this life and the next. But I also want to talk about the fact that I guess there's no real Muslim organization that deals with, these celebrity converts, whether, they're traditional celebrities like Sinead O'Connor, or maybe, the YouTube personality celebrities, because that comes with a whole set of different challenges that we've never seen before. And, during the Prophet's time, peace be upon him, there were instances in which you had very influential people during the Prophet's time who converted to Islam, and beyond. Once, the Prophet passed on, these companions of the Prophet went out into different areas of the globe, and, they, concentrate on giving dawah to the nobles, the leaders, the tribal chiefs, right? Because those tribal chiefs had an influence on their tribe, on their people, right? So it was a very intelligent way of giving a big dawah. They would give dawah to anybody, but there's a kind of this special focus of people who had large influences, right? So they were very adept at giving the best advice on how to not just bring this high status person into Islam, but also, the people surrounding him as well. Skipping ahead to 2023, this is really new territory for, mosques and Muslim organizations, because now you're dealing with an online world, right? Where, you have hundreds of thousands, if not millions of followers, but you can't really see them. It's almost like, a theater, like where you can't see the people watching you. And, who knows how many people, as a ripple effect, are going to convert to Islam because they looked into it, because Sneako himself converted to Islam. That in and of itself is a huge thing right there. But just in general, I think one of the, things that Sneako's been doing really well is that he's been connecting himself with Muslims of knowledge, like Sheikh Uthman in particular, and even, the three Muslims. He's always asked, what are the next steps? And, what should I be doing? What should I not be doing? Because it seems like he wants to, he's very sincere and he wants to, jump right in. And he wants to stay away from things that are forbidden in Islam, such as wearing gold and drinking alcohol. So that in and of itself is such a huge thing. I mean, that I think a lot of Muslims don't realize what huge life changes these are. If we look at the original companions of the Prophet, peace be upon them all, our beloved companions, many of them, it took years for them to, quit drinking alcohol, stop eating pork, to wear the hijab. That was not an immediate process. So I think that's good that, he's actually making a lot of positive changes, you can see. But not just in that, also the fact that, I think the way that he's been communicating with these other influencers, in the whole online world, whether that's Red Pill or ones who are not associated with the Red Pill movement. If you look at how he talks to people, he hasn't changed who he is, right? So it's not like he changed the way he dressed, aside from not wearing gold anymore. Sneako is still Sneako. He still wears the same clothing. He still talks the same way. He's even trying to clean up his language and the way he speaks, but you can tell that he hasn't changed who he is. And I think that's a really important thing that a lot of converts, they fall prey to, because, maybe they come from a culture or a background where Islam is not part of their history, or maybe it's, Islam is a complete antithesis to their history, or they've had conflict historically with Muslims. They will, change everything about them until they're unrecognizable. But I think, just the basic fact that Sneako has not cut himself off completely from this large influence that he has, I think is a really good thing. And this is a delicate time when someone first converts to Islam, because, they want to tell everyone about it. They want to, be a representative of the Muslim community. But, they're almost, going into, stepping into a new whole way of life that has many different, that has so many, where there's just absolutely so much to learn, right? But he's still, I think he took some time off to study it on his own. He didn't tell him, he don't tell many people about it. He's very private about him studying Islam, which I think is a good thing, because, you can learn new things about the religion. So then when you actually do give these interviews, you have the proper knowledge background. I mean, obviously you don't have them as much time to become a scholar, but you at least have a, you at least know some things about Islam, so you can actually, take part in these conversations with people, which I think is a really good thing. So general advice to Brother Sneako, though, is, I think those are all really good things. Keep doing what you're doing. You're not cutting ties with the people who are still involved with you. And you're not letting it get to you, the fact that you're encountering a lot of haters on the internet, because you also have a lot of support. You're getting a lot of support from your followers who weren't Muslim. If they're supporting your conversion, they're still sticking to your channel, and you still have a lot to say, about, masculinity and the globalization and things like that. And stick, don't change who you are, which is great. Continue, you're continuing to learn, which is also really good. But I think, in general, I mean, there's a lot of things really that you have to navigate through as well that are also challenges. And part of that is, the life after, when you know press stop on like you know recording your Rumble podcast, you know, because at the end of the day, you still you still have to be in your in your social group, and you still have to go to sleep at the end of the night and wake up at the in the next morning. You still have these errands that you have to run, and I don't know what his social circles is like, but you definitely need to be surrounded by people who are good influences, you know, whether they're Muslim or not, but preferably, you know, the more Muslims that you have within your inner circle, the better environment that you're gonna have, where you feel like, you know, you're getting, you know, spiritually fulfilled, you know, like you're around people who are good influences, you know, who are not being not acting, you know, toxic and degenerate and things like that. And I think, you know, he's got such a pull that he can actually get like a crew like this, you know, or maybe he has an existing crew where, you know, they hang out together and, you know, they do things together, you know, so that you're around like these people who are good influences. I think one thing that, you know, like might be good is that you're, you know, again, like Sneako is continuing to learn, but I think, you know, like, learning about the dynamics, you know, men and women in Islam is very, very, very comprehensive, and you know, there's lots to learn in that field. And the red pill movement is so relatively new that there hasn't really been a detailed kind of like analysis from an Islamic perspective on where people agree, the aspects where people agree, and where Islam is in concordance with the red pill movement and not in concordance with the red pill movement. Because I think it's important to, you know, separate and understand that these are, at the end of the day, two different ideologies, you know. And so instead of making the red pill movement to kind of make Islam conform to the red pill movement, it has to be the other way around. And I think, you know, Sneako did a good job of explaining that when he was on Fresh, when he was debating with Fresh and Fit. You know, like the whole idea that, you know, in order to be a high value man, you have to sleep around with a whole bunch of women, you know, to understand their mindset. I mean, that just doesn't hold any water, first of all. And secondly, it's completely anathema or totally against, you know, what Islam teaches. You know, Islam teaches chastity, to not get into relationships before marriage. And you know, that's going to corrupt you, really. If you, the more you're into these types of marriages, it's going to corrupt you and severely inhibit your ability to be a father and, you know, to be a husband, you know, to raise a family and that. And I think Sneako is really good at driving that home during that debate, without even having to mention Islam, you know, like, and I think people, you know, I think he definitely won and got his points across really strongly. And again, I'm not trying to overpraise Brother Sneako here. I think, you know, everyone's going to go through growing pains and challenges, and he's going to make a lot of mistakes along the way, you know, but I think he has the right idea that, you know, when you do convert to Islam and you have this kind of social media influencer role, that you try to get absorb as much knowledge as you can before you say something that you don't, that you don't know the answer to. You know, so I think that's really good for him, and I think that's a good template, you know, that other influencers can use if they do convert to Islam. Right. Now, I mean, one thing I do, you know, want to mention is that, you know, there is going to be a lot of challenges associated with marriage, because I know that he was talking about marriage, you know, with the three Muslims. I had a chance to watch that particular interview, and a lot of the stuff they talk about is just theoretical. Like, it's not real. No, it's not really what goes on in the real world, because they talked about, you know, the sanctity of marriage and how it's really important for Muslim men to get married as opposed to being in extramarital relationships. But I think kind of what they didn't tell them is that, you know, the way that Muslim societies normally function is that the family will look into finding a potential spouse for their son or daughter, you know, because they already have these kind of tight social networks. It's, you know, the father who usually investigates and tries to find, you know, suitable candidates, and then they'll meet as a group. You know, there's not a dating thing. It's more like a get together between the families where they discuss, you know, if these two people are going to be compatible. But when you're a convert to Islam, as we know, you don't have any of this. You don't have any of this family structure. So it's you can't just copy and paste what born Muslims do and say, okay, this is going to work for converts. So it's a very delicate situation that Sneako is in, and I don't. It's going to be one of the biggest life decisions that he makes. Like figuring out, who to marry, and the whole dynamics about, how this marriage is supposed to function, right? Definitely, I mean, you want to keep it private. I think Sneako and all the other Muslim influencers who've converted realize that because, having a public style marriage where where this spouse of yours is not going to be visible in your podcast and stuff. I mean, there's a lot of pitfalls that can be associated with that. Like marrying into a completely different culture. I don't think they realize. I don't think a lot of these big Muslim influencer YouTubers understand that when you're marrying into a totally different culture, there's going to be a lot of arguments and there's going to be a lot of differences that they don't really tell you about in the book. You can't buy a book on this stuff. It may be a good idea to, looking into marrying someone who's another convert or who's one of your followers to begin with. But also, I mean, that comes with its own pitfalls as well. So, how the families get along, are they just going to be on their own? Are they going to be involved? And this goes hand in hand with, who Sneako's inner circles are going to be. So I think he's gonna have to take things really carefully and be very selective about who he's going to choose to marry. And obviously, I mean, I know that a lot of these social media influencers, especially the Tate brothers, have an inordinate amount of wealth. So financially, they may be able to take care of more than one wife, but do we really want to recommend that for someone who has just converted to Islam? That's a big question because, the whole multiple wives argument that has such created such a fervor when it comes to the online debating world and the red pill movement. A lot of non-Muslims and people who don't like Islam have a lot of strong opinions towards polygamy. And Muslims who are involved in the red pill movement are very, very, very pro-polygamy, even though like polygamy is allowed in Islam with caveats. I mean, you can't just marry for women willy-nilly. You have to be able to take care of them equally, support them equally. That is a very difficult thing to do. And I don't care how much money you have, when you first convert to Islam, there's enough challenges that you have to deal with already. Now to throw into the mix the fact that you're not just going to get married, marry more than one wife, maybe from a totally different cultural background. You have to worry about the family dynamics of dealing with more than one set of Muslim in-laws if they're born Muslims. My advice to Sneako in that regard and the Tate brothers is with that is to tread lightly, to be very selective about thinking about who you're going to marry in this particular instance. You want someone that's culturally compatible with you, who's on the same page as you. Not just that, but their family and their inner circle as well. It's that's going to be a challenge, but may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help these brothers who have just converted to Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep them on the straight path. And that's just my general advice to Sneako and even the Tate brothers or any other social media influencer who might convert to Islam, that you have a large following still. You don't want to cut ties with people because you still have an influence on them. But my best advice is to take some time off, take some time to learn the religion properly and privately. I think Sneako did the right thing in that regard. And there may be instances where you may need to cut ties with people who are being such a bad influence. But again, Allah replaces that with something better. You're going to find a lot of people who want to be part of your crew, like your internal crew. And you want to make those people a part of your life as long as they're a good influence on you. And then lastly, I mean, you want to be careful when it comes to, who you're going to marry, because it's not a copy and paste method. That's not going to work because the way that born Muslims work is that their families are already heavily involved. But for converts, we're on our own basically. he's probably the only Muslim in his family, and that's going to take a lot of building this kind of social network, where you're eventually going to bring a lucky sister into your life, to make and then inshallah start a family. Okay, and then above all, you want to keep it private. Who knows, what kind of detractors are going to be after you, if and when that does happen. So, yep. So that's all my time for today. Please like and subscribe to Islam for Europeans. I'm your host, Robert. Coming soon, we'll be trying to get the take these surveys soon, inshallah, so we get more of an opinion on non-Muslims' attitudes towards Islam and things such of that nature. But that's all my time for the day. Assalamu alaikum. Rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.